Welcome back. This is part two of the Treadwell Project. The Treadwell Project is a series of videos that I'm doing on the construction and building of a Treadwell droid from Star Wars. In this video, we are doing the mast. The mast is the center section of the droid and is where all the arms will be attached. Let's get started. So these are all the parts that we're going to use to make this mast. The first piece that we're going to need is this 3D printed part. The 3D printed part, it's the base. I did this on an FDM printer. I'm using aluminum parts for everything else that's going to be made for this mast. These little parts are all pre-cut. The aluminum tubing is all from an online metal supply, and I got it all cut so that the inner diameter and the outer diameter would all fit together accordingly. And basically each one of these little parts would slide over a larger part or a smaller part. In the case of the mast is about, overall, it's about 31 or 32 inches long, and each one of these pieces needs to slide over that main tube, and buying all of these on this online metal supply place made it easy for me to figure out which parts went where and what sizes I needed. I was able to order the inside diameter and the outside diameter that I wanted, and then be able to kind of fit them all together. When they arrive, none of them really fit together properly. So I do need to go through and sand and probably lay out the interiors of them and the exteriors of them so that they all fit together properly. And you know, a big part of this video is going to be how we do that. You cannot do a project without sanding. So as in all of my videos, there is lots and lots of sanding in this one as well. This is the 3D printed part. It is the base of the mast, and it is 3D printed because it doesn't need to really support any weight. The mast actually sits on the frame of the base of the droid. So this piece actually is just making sure that the mast stays upright, and it does a fairly good job. My other Treadwell has this exact same part. I'm going to make this part available on Thingiverse, and I will put a link in the description for this piece. And like all other 3D printed parts, they do need to be finished. So there is a great deal of sanding, there is filling, and there is going to be painting and priming and all of that good stuff. And then we're going to repeat and do it all over again. I'm going to save you guys all of that pain and fast forward through all of it and just show you this little piece of sanding. And then we're going to move on to the rest of the build. It's worth noting that this particular piece is made of ABS. And I basically do this process with all of my 3D printed parts. I start off with I think it's about 120 or 150 grit sandpaper on the rotary sander. Typically, I'll start with that and get it sanded down as much as possible. And then I'll come back with, say, something like 220 and do all of that prior to adding primer. So that's what you're seeing here. I got this square stock from an online source as well. Same place I got the tubing from. It's all aluminum. It's all pre-cut. It's all sized appropriately. And basically, I just need to give it a little bit of sanding. I need to get all the markings off of it. And these four pieces are going to be used in the four corners that will help hold up or help support the corners of that base or that 3D printed part. And that whole thing is going to become the very, very top portion of the base. The four bar stock need to be tapped and drilled out and tapped. I'm going to use a center punch to mark the center point of each of them. And there's a hole already in the base for where the screw goes through. And I'm using 6/32 screws for all of these parts. Once all the holes are drilled, I'm using a 6/32 tap to thread all of the bar stock. As part of the sanding process, each one of the holes had to be enlarged a little bit. So in the 3D printed part, it needed to be a little bit larger. Typically with 3D printed parts, the holes aren't exactly perfect, and depending on your tolerances will depend on how much you need to sand it out. In this case, I'm using an 80 grit sanding wheel on a drill, and this 80 grit sanding wheel I used a lot for the inside of the tubes. Periodically, I would need to check the tube, make sure it fit inside the hole. I'm trying to get it to go a certain distance into it, so I just needed to be sanded out until it actually slid in there very easily. The tube only needs to go into the base 2 inches. So I wanted to make sure that the tubing that was sticking out the bottom was at the same distance that each one of those little legs would be. With the part sanded and the tube fitting inside of it, it was time to paint. So I'm using a filler primer. This primer is great. It basically fills in little holes and scratches and dents and things like that. Still will need to be sanded afterwards, but this really gets you a long ways in terms of getting the part to look good. Okay, once the primer dried, now time to sand some more. I do a light sanding on this one. I tend to go 220 grit. This way it helps the next layer of paint stick to it. Also, it helps knock off any imperfections and smooth out any scratches and things of that nature. You could go 320, I suppose, but 220 works fine. Once the part's sanded, primed, sanded, you get the gist of this. Now it's time to paint. So this is aluminum enamel, and I'm using this as the base color for this. I'm not going to do the weathering on this, just like the head. I will do that later on. So this piece of aluminum right here needs to be sanded out about 5 or 6 inches. It is the 30-inch piece of aluminum tubing. It's 2 inches in diameter with a 1 3/4 inch interior diameter. The piece I'm trying to slide into it is 1 3/4 inch outer diameter. And so it's just, I'm trying to sand it out so that the smaller piece will slide into it. I actually have the tubing connected to my ventilation system or to my dust collection. And I have the tube just shoved into the hose. And that way when I sand, all the sanding particles are going up into the ventilation. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, I used a lathe to get some of the parts to fit together. I have a small little hobbyist lathe. It won't do very large parts, and I'm really pushing it on terms of the size of the diameter of these pieces. So it allows me, though, to kind of thin out these parts. It also allows me to lathe out the inner walls. So it was very quick to make all these parts fit together and make sure that the one would slide over the other. You only have a few pieces that do that. Actually, all the 3-inch pieces and the 1.5-inch piece all have to slide over the 30-inch, 2-inch diameter tube, and the lathe made easy work of all of it. So one of the things I had to do is I had to adjust the knurling tool. I have a knurling tool for the lathe. You know, it's a tool that fits right inside of the tool holder. However, because of the size of the tubes, I can't get it far enough away from the tube to, you know, make it work. So I had to 3D print a custom holder for the knurler that held the knurler away from the tool holder and back away from the work a little bit. So that allowed me to go in and lay the knurling in place. This is something I made for my other Treadwell, so I already had made it. It's a little beat up and a little worse for wear, because it's not really designed for this. But it worked fairly well, and it put enough pressure on there to create the knurling that I wanted to do. Each small piece of tubing required its own placement of knurling, so each one was a little bit different. Because of that, I've drawn up plans for the mast, just like I did for the head, so I will post where you can find the plans for this mast and where the placement of the knurling would be. Each one of these parts need to be drilled out or have a hole drilled through them. We're going to use a set screw to hold each one of them in place in a particular spot on the actual mast. So the main body of the mast is a 2-inch pipe that has a 1 3/4 inch inner diameter. There is a 12-inch piece of 1 3/4 inch diameter pipe inserted into it, and I'm going to use a set screw to hold this in place. For this particular part, it has to be extra strong just because that 1 3/4 inch piece is going to be all the way through to the base, and that's where all the weight and all the stress will be. So I'm just using 2 set screws. Don't look at this third set screw. I actually mismeasured and it's not in the right place, so we'll talk about that later. Again, using a 6/32 tap to tap all the way through to the bottom pipe. And this is just going to tie the two poles together and really, you know, make it nice and solid. And basically all of the different parts or all the parts will be done this exact same way. Now, the bottom part or the 1¾-inch pipe and the 2-inch pipe are attached to each other. It's nice and solid. I'm actually going to ultimately cut off a little bit off the bottom of this pipe just because I left it a little bit too long for the overall length of the mast. And every one of the other pipe pieces slide over the 2-inch part. I tried to make this as easy as possible. So basically there are, I think it's 5 3-inch by 2.5-inch pipe. And the 2.5-inch pipe, each 3 inches long, have an inside diameter of 2 inches. There is one piece, a 3-inch piece, that has an inside diameter of 2.5 inches, and it's 2¾ inches on its outside diameter. There is one small 1.5-inch piece that is also 2.5 inches in diameter with a 2-inch diameter on the inside. Without going into a lot of detail about where each one of these are placed, this was kind of figured out long ago. And I believe this was originally the first set of plans for Treadwell were designed by Dave Everett. I think that he was really, really close in a lot of ways. And I've only modified it a little bit based off his original drawings. Basically, what I'm doing here is I'm just making sure that each hole in the aluminum pipes, outer pipes, are in the back or the what will be the back of the mast. And then I'm marking where I need to drill the holes for the set screws. So I'm gonna, based on my measurements, based on the dimensions, again, all of that will be in the plans. And I really want the, you know, holes to all line up. So I'm just going through and measuring everything out beforehand. The holes here are all drilled and tapped. I didn't think it was necessary to show you that part of the build process again. Seen that enough already in this video, so. Now it's just a matter of slipping the parts on and inserting the set screw. Now it's just a matter of attaching the bar stock to the base. Everything was done beforehand, so drilled everything out, tapped everything, and now just attaching everything to the base. So added a set screw from the base to the mast. I also drilled a larger hole for the wires to pass through that go from the head and from the neck area down to the base of the body where the batteries will be and the controllers and everything will be down there. Disconnected the head from the previous setup. The previous setup was in the last video. I now need to connect or run the wires down through the mast. So there's two sets of wires coming from the head. Basically, there's a wire that provides power to the receiver inside the eye stalk. And then there are the two wires running from the motor, which will control the neck. So I'm extending the motor wires because the wire running to the servo or to the receiver is actually 5 or 6 feet long, but the motor wires need to be extended all the way down the mast. Splicing the wires together just so that they are ready for solder and a heat shrink tube that's gonna wrap around them. Okay, holding the wires in place and just really quickly just soldering the two ends together using two heat shrink tubes here to cover each one of the solder joints. Sliding a larger piece of heat shrink tube over the whole operation. This is to protect all the wires going down into the mast. There's going to be additional stuff running back up to the mast. I want to make sure this is well protected. One last hole to tap or drill out and tap. The neck needs a set screw. This one pipe right here, this one piece of aluminum tubing that is connected between the motor mounts is going to slide down into the pipe of the mast, the main pipe. And this one little piece will be holding the head in the right position or the neck in the right position and support the weight of the motor and everything basically. So first drill it out, then simply tap it. Again, I'm using 6/32 screws and a 632 tap, and that way everything kind of matches and looks the same. Okay, it's now ready to go together. So I need to feed the wire down through the mast, basically pulling on the wire on the other end. This was a little tricky as I was trying to hold onto the head and trying to hold onto the mast, get everything to line up properly, get everything to slide together without putting undue stress on the head. I undid the set screw for the very, very top piece there, just so I could get the set screw into the next section. It's important that the next section screw goes down below the surface of the aluminum. That way that top piece can slide back into place. Once it's attached, then that top section could go back in and the set screw reinstalled. There you have it with the finished mast and the head attached. This is going to wrap up this video and this section of the build. Thank you for watching. If you find this content interesting, please consider subscribing. We'll see you on the next one.